Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Energy Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good morning and welcome. Open Heaven is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.E. Adebwe, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. We are glad you joined us today. God bless you so much. Today's date is Sunday, the second day of August 2020. And our topic for today is a very important one. It says, Behold, He cometh. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we appreciate you. We thank you for this privilege to be at your feet. Lord, we do not take it for granted. We ask that your word would come to us with simplicity and power today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. You're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 7. It says, Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. Revelation chapter 1 verse 7. Our Bible reading is from the book of Acts chapter 1 from verse 9 to 11. Acts 1 from verse 9 to 11 says, And when he had spoken these things while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfast towards heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus which is taken from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. May God bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name. Amen. You will agree with me that the issue of the second coming of Jesus Christ is a very important one. And in recent times, we've had so much that has been said about it. And to an extent, it has become a controversial issue. We have different kind of doctrines flying around. Some argue that Jesus will not come again, while others even say that he has come secretly already. But with all of this, we would like to know what the scripture actually says about this. And like we have seen from our memory verse and our Bible reading, we can tell that Jesus is coming back again. And when he is coming back, all eyes will see him. We can support this fact with so many scriptures. So we would like to learn more about what the scripture says. We know from the scripture that Jesus went into heaven publicly. He went in the full view of his disciples. And while he ascended, his disciples were still staring above. We had angels who ministered to them and told them that Jesus was returning in the same manner. And this same manner now implies that he was going to come back publicly. The Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 16 that for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. Descending with a shout does not sound like something that can be done in the secret. It also debunks the lie that Christ is not going to return. So we can see two clear facts now, that he is going to return and his return is going to be public. So that is settled. The next point that we would like to discuss today is that he will return with clouds and every eye, including the eyes of those people who crucified him, shall see him. But now the shame of those who crucified him will be unimaginable. And why will it be unimaginable? Revelation 1 verse 7 says that the kindred of the earth shall wail. Why is this so? It is because they have refused to repent of their sins. They have procrastinated so much. They have refused to believe. And now Jesus is here. The door for that pardon is closed. And they will have to face his full wrath. They will now have to face Jesus, who is the righteous judge. And he will definitely judge them according to their works. So this is spelling doom for them already. Revelation chapter 6 verse 17 tells us, For the great day of his wrath is come. And who shall be able to stand? This is a very serious question that we must ask even our own selves. Who shall be able to stand? Now, looking at the scripture in Psalm 24 verse 3, it says, Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? This is a similar question to who shall be able to stand. The next verse goes on to answer the question. It says, he that has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity nor sworn deceitfully. We must take note that it says he that had clean hands and a pure heart. The cleanliness of our hands is not in the fact that we do good works. It is in the fact that we have accepted the person of Jesus Christ and his sacrifice for us. We have accepted Jesus Christ as the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the whole world. This is inclusive of our own sins also. It is by this way that our hands are made clean and our hearts are transformed by the working of his Spirit in us. Only such a man can stand before him. Any man who has not accepted the gift of Jesus Christ, the gift of the Son of God himself that was given to take away our sins, that man cannot stand before God. We know the popular scripture, John 3 verse 16, that tells us, for God so loved the world. So it was out of love that he gave his only begotten Son. He gave him out to die, so that whosoever would believe and confess him as Lord and Savior would not die, would not perish, but have eternal life. Whosoever, doesn't matter the race, the religion, the tribe, ethnicity, whatever. The point is that you just come and surrender and believe. It is with the heart that we believe and with the mouth we make confessions. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 2, the latter part, that behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. You see, there's no need to procrastinate anymore. There's no need to postpone that day. The Bible says that in the day that you hear his voice, do not harden your heart. There's repercussion for hardening of heart. And this opening that we have is not lasting forever. There's a period and a season to it. Whoever does not make this decision within that period would bow his head in shame that day that Jesus will return. He will not be able to look into the face of Jesus. Just like Adam and Eve were ashamed when they fell. That will not be our portion in the name of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, I know we've heard so many times that Jesus is coming soon. But I would like to tell us that this may even be sooner than we may want to accept or believe. So many of us will argue that this is the same story we've heard. Our grandparents were told the same thing, our parents heard the same thing, and now the same story is coming to us. But please, may you also know that if the Lord Jesus does not appear in the sky during your lifetime, then you would go and meet him. Either ways, your Jesus Christ would have come. But one thing remains for sure. The scripture tells us that it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death, judgment. So if our Lord Jesus does not come during our lifetime, and we have the cost to go to meet him, then we must be very sure that the moment we close our eyes, there is no more room for repentance. The only chance that we have is right now, today, the day of salvation. We must stop hardening our hearts and postponing that date because we are not so sure of the next minute. One of the worst things that can happen to any man is to meet his Savior unprepared. He will be full of regrets, and then there will be no opportunity to rewrite his wrongs. This is a very crucial decision because many of us have known our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as the Lamb of God. We've heard it over and over again, and maybe that's why it doesn't carry weight to us. But we must also know that this time around, he's not coming back as the Lamb of God. He's coming back as the righteous judge. He's coming back as a king. He's not coming back to die for the sins of men again. He's coming back rather to execute judgment. There are so many reasons and excuses that we give now because we do not want to surrender to him. Many of us still believe that we are young. But that's the deceit, a lie of the devil. We are expected to look forward to this day, the day when we would see our Savior face to face. This should be the joy and hope of every believer. Scripture tells us in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 19 that if in this life only we have hope in Christ, then we are of all men most miserable. One reason for the joy and peace in our hearts is knowing the fact that even beyond our existence on this earth, there is so much more waiting in store for us. Jesus told us that I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. Now he has been preparing that place for over 2,000 years. You can imagine how that place would be, a place that has been in continuous making for 2,000 years. Brethren, please do not make anything sway your feet from making it to that place. If you have not known and accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then please, it is not too late to do that. You can say this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe you died for me. I believe that I am a sinner. Please come into my heart and transform me today. I receive your life into my spirit, and I begin to walk in your righteousness from this moment onwards in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have said that prayer, I want you to know that you have received a new life. You are a transformed man, and you must begin to walk in that light. Please find a Bible-believing church and plant yourself there so that you may grow. I congratulate you. And if you've accepted Him as your Lord and Savior, then you should ask for the grace to hold on faithfully to the end. Because it is he who endures to the end that receives the promise. There is no reward for any man that draws back. At this point, I would like us to bow our heads and pray and say, Father, please prepare me for the second coming of your Son and my Savior Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus. Father, please prepare me. Help me by your Spirit that I will be made ready for the Master's coming. Help me not to procrastinate. Help me not to enjoy the deceitfulness of the devil. I refuse to be swayed away. I refuse to be distracted. Help me to always be at alert. And that in that day I would hear you say unto me, Welcome, good and faithful servant, come into your rest. Receive more grace to stand faithfully till the end. In the name of Jesus. Eternal Father, we thank you for your word that we've heard today. And like always, you keep refreshing us daily. Lord, we ask that you keep us by yourself till the end. Help us that we will by no means draw back. Strengthen us that our gaze will be fixed on you, and that in the end we would see you face to face in the name of Jesus. We refuse to buy into the deception of the devil. Thank you for answering our prayers. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. Thank you for joining us today. I pray for us that none of us will be missing on that great day in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. If you'd like to speak to someone or to be a part of our online community, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80986 11226. That is +234 80986 11226. Have a blessed Sunday ahead. God bless you mightily in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.